A radioactive source can emit different types of radiation, such as alpha particles, gammas, or beta particles. The question now is, what will happen when these particles pass through matter? My name is Jan Heijsen, and in this video we will discuss the interaction of radiation with matter. When radiation passes through matter, it will interact with the atoms of the material it passes through. How will it interact, and how probable is the interaction? This will depend on the type of energy of radiation and the type of matter it is passing through. Charged particles and photons will mainly lose energy or be scattered by interactions with the electrons circling the atoms of the material they pass through. We can state that their interaction is mainly determined by atomic physics. The ways of interaction can be subdivided in two large groups, depending on the type of particle. When a particle passes through a slab of matter, it can either undergo a large number of small interactions in which it is scattered slightly and loses a small part of its energy during each interaction, or it can be eliminated in a single all-or-nothing interaction. Let us consider now a parallel beam of monoenergetic particles. In the case of particles undergoing multiple small interactions, the energy of the particles will be degraded. There will be a spread on the energy of the particles in the beam after passing through the slab of material. By increasing the slab thickness, particles will lose more and more energy. As long as the particles do not lose all of their energy, all particles will pass through the slab of material. Starting at a certain slab thickness, some of the particles will have lost all of their energy. They will be fully stopped in the material. If we keep increasing the thickness of the slab, more and more particles will be stopped until eventually no more particles are passing through. The average thickness at which the particles in the beam are stopped is called the range. This range is typical for this particular type of radiation with this specific energy in this specific material. In the case of particles undergoing all-or-nothing interactions, the characteristics of the beam passing through the slab will be different from the previous case. Since in this case particles can pass through the slab of material without undergoing any interaction, the transmitted beam will have the same average energy as the original beam. However, some of the particles are eliminated in all-or-nothing interactions, so the number of particles passing through will decrease when the thickness of the slab increases. The number of particles that interact in a slice of material is proportional to the number of incident particles and to the thickness of the slice. Therefore, the number of transmitted particles will decrease exponentially with the thickness of the material. In this case, no range can be defined, but rather an attenuation coefficient mu and a mean free path, which is the average distance traveled by a particle before it interacts. The value of this mean free path is given by 1 divided by mu. Let us now discuss some radiation types in more detail. We will focus on the interaction of the 3 specific types of radiation we mentioned earlier. Heavy charged particles, such as alpha particles, high energy photons, called gamma rays, and electrons or positrons, called beta particles. Heavy charged particles lose their energy mostly through many small collisions with bound electrons in the material via Coulomb or electromagnetic interaction. The charged particle can lift a bound electron to a higher energy state and leave an atom of the material in an excited state. It can also strip an electron from the atom, in which case we talk about ionization. Photons interact with matter through 3 main processes: the photoelectric effect, the Compton effect, and pair production. In the photoelectric effect, a photon is absorbed by an atom, which in turn emits a bound electron. In the Compton effect, the photon bounces off a free electron. In matter, electrons are not really free, but bound to atoms. However, if the photon energy is high enough, the binding with the atom can be neglected. The photon is scattered and will transfer a part of its energy to the electron. During pair production, a photon with sufficient energy will produce an electron-positon pair according to Einstein's well-known equation E equals mc squared. In order to conserve energy and momentum, this can only occur in the electromagnetic field of an atomic nucleus. In two of the three cases discussed above, the photon is eliminated during the interaction process. Also, in the case of Compton scattering, the scattered photon can be eliminated in a subsequent photoelectric effect or pre-production event. Therefore, the all-or-nothing type of interaction is a good approximation for the interaction of photons with matter. The three processes have very different energy dependencies. The photoelectric effect will dominate at lower energies. At these energies, the Compton effect is rather small in comparison, but it becomes more important at intermediate energies. For sufficiently high energies, pair production becomes the dominant process. The attenuation coefficient mu for photons can thus be written as a sum of three terms. To conclude, let's have a look at electrons and positrons. At lower energies, they lose their energy through collisions when passing through matter, just like heavy charged particles do. During these collisions, they can excite or ionize the atoms in the matter they've passed through. Above a certain critical energy, an additional energy loss mechanism becomes important, Bremsstrahlung. In this process, electromagnetic radiation is emitted due to the acceleration or deceleration of the electron or positron in the electromagnetic field of a nucleus. The total energy loss of electrons and positrons is therefore the sum of two parts, a collision term and a radiation term. And with these particles, we have reached the end of our overview of how radiation interacts with matter. Thank you for your attention.